So even Chase Bank, Jamie Dimon, says that the Fed has effed up. Well, he said screwed up. Jamie Dimon calls on central banks 100% dead wrong. And you know what's going to be dead? Well, that would be all of us. Cue the fire. Why you say that, Bravo? Why so drama? And what's wrong with your hair? Well, I had a fight with the light socket today and I lost, so my apologies. But I will tell you what is wrong and what the problems are. One, it's the banks. Banks wrong, Fed wrong, government officials wrong, Jerome wrong, Janet wrong, everyone wrong. In T-minus 60 days, everyone's going to be pointing fingers for this gigantic dumpster fire. See, Jamie right now is pointing it at Janet, saying, what are you doing, a trillion? Another trillion and another trillion. I say, hey, Jamie, your hands are dirty too, and all the banks all run into the Fed. See that? That's not going down. That's called an emergency. This is all of the banks running to the Fed and saying, we need a loan because we're in trouble. Or they call it a bank term funding program. And you know there's a problem when the banks need the loans. But that's not the only problem these banks are facing. Oh, there's more to come just in the next March. It's all coming in March. All of these advances, you know? There's a problem when you need an advance and coming in from Finance-A-Lot. Blue bars are emergency FHLB loans to be repaid by the banks within 1 year. It's a ticking. If you look at the dates, these loans ramp up dramatically from September 2022, well until March 24. Banks are going to be out of liquidity. A banking crisis makes sense, and the Fed will make sure it happens, well, right about now. And these guys are, everyone's going to be pointing fingers. And then even, do you guys see what's happening with regular humans? How about that 2024 election? And a poll was just taken. They asked you, is there going to be violence? Are you going to take to the streets? Are you going to have pitchforks? And I think it's kind of a racist picture there. Gray hair should be offended. But do you know how, what percentage of you, the population, is going to take to the streets? I've been saying this, get out of the cities. You guys have a few minutes left. Among Biden supporters, 41%. Can we just round up? Half. Because once it starts going, they're like, yeah, let's get some. Violence is justified to stop Republicans. And Republicans, you're not too far behind. Almost 40% embrace violence to stop Democrats. And coming in from a WTF moment, you guys are gearing up for this. Woohoo! Americans panic buying of ammunition. Prices surged almost 40% in a week. Bravo! The markets went up today. What's going on? Well, that's because markets go up and down. And also, stop looking at the stock market as if like it's a meter to how we're doing. Call those people in 1929. One day everything's great. The next day, cue the fire, burn this thing down, complete panic, which is actually right around this day. And if you would like to get a bigger picture of how the economy is going, take a look at the Dow Jones Transportation Average. Look, this is not good. This is goods and services moving around in an economy, not so good. Also, be careful of this Bitcoin pump. I'm telling you, it's not that I'm not bullish on it, it's just when you have candles that go off into infinity and beyond, yeah, those 99.999% of the time do not play out when you have one chart going this way and then the other one going that way. Also, just to rewind the tape, when I've been trading Bitcoin forever, I remember the last recession, 3,800. Now, I'm not saying it's going to go there. I'm just saying don't go FOMO. I mean, just learn how to trade this stuff. At least you're making calculated risks, right? Like the nine count comes on, it starts getting purple, right? You're losing to, you're getting red. That usually means there's going to be a pullback and you can make money all the way down until again. But I mean, this wasn't even much of a reprieve. That is the 200-day moving average for Dow's, the Dow's transportation of stuff moving around. Also, if you want to learn how to do this, swing trade, I'm doing the 199 because everyone's trying to get into my options course. But you got to start swing trade first. Start jumping the pitchfork on fire and going like, I got this. I'm ready to blow up my account. Also, know when I am done filming my options course, all prices go up. If you're like, but I still can't even get the darn code in the description. Well, I'm sorry. It's starting to loosen up. So relax. I've currently filmed 72 videos. Want to probably get it up to 100. Now, coming in from, I can't wait until you have to pay this back in your taxes, which is right now. Oh, maybe that's what's happening. And I know this. I know the heartbeat of America, and it's not good. Because I know, I hear you, and I see it, and, you know, like, people, like normal people, I'm so tired of feeling helpless as a parent when she goes on and says, you got to work hard, you go to college, you get a job, you save for your house, you can't get a house, you can't afford anything. And they are struggling and drowning, and they can't figure it out. She was really mad, and those are those eyes that I was talking about. She used the F word a lot. She probably needs to call me, and I'll explain it to her, which I've been saying this for a while. It's a debt-based system, okay? It's going to wipe you all out, and it's mathematically correct. Oh, look, deficit doubling. That's weird. But this is why you're not making it with the American dream. It's not. It's gone because you've elected politicians. It doesn't, you know, whatever. It would have probably ended this way anyways. Everyone thinks that, you know, the new king is going to fix this. It's not. $2 trillion on top of what we can't. We're way over. This is ridiculous. 34 trillion. No one's even blinking, but everyone's starving to death. Just can't connect the dots. Look at the interest on debt. It's almost $1 trillion. Here, I'll connect the dots for you. Here's a few of them. Why this whole thing cannot mathematically work. U.S. workforce, now and 23 years ago, we've added nothing. Not in labor force, we've added a lot. The one that I want you to look at is this one. Median income now, 36,000. In 23 years ago was 32. 3, 4, 5, 6. Wow! Making a whole $4,000 more a year over the last 23 years. Oh, and then there's this inflation thing. House used to be 1 and now it's 4 and everything else. So yes, you're not keeping up. You're not going to be able to keep up. Only solution, start businesses every single year. Swing trade, have this stuff, right? Money, gold, have silver, have assets, teach your kids about assets, teach them about starting businesses. I don't care. It could be a lemonade stand. I made every one of my kids get out there and do a lemonade stand. The best of my knowledge, every single one of my kids owns businesses. That's just how it is. Jump in the share of households having difficulties. You're having difficulties paying expenses in October? Oh, looky here. All-time high. Oh, and wait, this just in, breaking news. U.S. mortgage rate surges to 8.35. Yeah, go out there and get that home. This is higher than 23 years ago. And you know why you can't get that home? Because the economy's great. You're doing great with so many jobs, making so much money. Oh, wait. Oh, that chart was saying that you're not making so much money. Oh, and wait, more breaking news. This just in. Car owners fall behind on payments at highest rate on record since forever. Everything's fine. Nothing to see here. Everything is just fine. If the economy was so good and everything was so great, I wouldn't be reading stories of falling behind. Bankruptcies, highest on record. Kids can't make it. No one can make it. Not good. I also come bearing solutions, but you're not going to like the solutions to all of this. Any president that's tried to go against, see that money creation, how money is created, and this whole bond thing, which is in the trillions, where money comes from debt, which makes no sense, right? Should be something like this. I think so. This is called hear it? Sound money. Because it even sounds like money. Oh, and by the way, there has been two presidents that have confronted this money thing. What do these two presidents have in common? They both died from lead poisoning. That's correct. See, the powers that be are not going to allow this. So that's why I take an approach of like, okay, I know how this is going to end. We're all just going to get an island and we will do our own. You can have gold as money, silver as money, seashells. I don't care. You won't have bond or bondage or money out of thin air, which that's what happens in the banking system, which has been really good for the banks. But yes, President Lincoln, $450 million directly from the U.S. Treasury. Huh. Well, that's interesting. That seems like it would be normal. These debt-free interest-free notes were known as greenbacks. Can you imagine that? Debt-free, interest-free notes. Oh, and then this cat, 1963. I don't even want to use this number because YouTube will probably pick it up on it. But it's some ones issuing $4.3 billion directly from the U.S. Treasury, bypassing the Federal Reserve. These debt-free, interest-free notes, known as silver certificates. So again, cue the fire, the show must go on. But I come here, and that's why you maybe, did you think about subscribing? Maybe go push it now. You're like, dang, you know what? I learned some stuff from this guy. I should hit that subscribe button. Even though YouTube won't push me out to you because they hate me. And actually, while you're looking at it, see if they've unsubscribed you. Guys, this is a gigantic big setup. I don't want you on the rug when it's pulled, and oh boy, I feel like you feel the tug. I mean, I feel the tug. Sometimes we like tugs, sometimes we don't. Real estate deals canceled at highest rate in nearly a year. Everyone's canceling. I thought it was great though. Guys, feel free. Go ahead, get into the stock market, but just make sure that you understand where the exit is. You enter, you exit. Ah, risk-free. Well, that's because we only paper trade on this channel. Rather than just buy and hold the bags for everyone. And then as investors are repeating a big mistake they made before the 2008 crash, the 2020, every crash. Oh, crash and financial crisis, top economist, well, Rosenberg. Guys may have seen David Rosenberg on CNBC, now market insider. He's the guy, let's see if I can get this joke right. Let's warm up here. It's called the last 50 of the last two market crashes. Did I get that right? But guys, it's true. What goes up must come down. Even though the market went, oh, look at that, went up today. You're under the 200-day moving average. Oh, and congratulations for the S&P 500 sitting on the 200-day moving average, dangling its little legs off of it. Thinking, are we going to jump or not? Well, you got to get above that blue line right there. Also, could we be setting up for a swing trade? I don't think so. Ah, but that's bad news. I got to give you some good news today. Oh, China's sell-off is showing signs of panic as investors flee. So be thankful you're not in China. How about that? And if you are, well, I'm sorry. But anywho, you guys, thanks for always hanging out. Thanks for your support, and I will see you tomorrow.